Yeah, a lot of the people in the story time, we either don't talk anymore, but there's no beef on my end, or we squashed everything and we're cool. So let's not start no kind of drama. If you know what this video, if you know who the people are in the story, let's not start no drama. Let's just keep it pushing, okay? Because this was years ago. I'm now 22. I graduated high school when I was 18 in 2018. It's now 2022. Let's leave the drama where the drama was at back there, okay? Disclaimer, this was all before my saved days. So whatever I did in the story time, this was before I got saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. I'm just letting y'all know because there's gonna be a little story, there's gonna be a little something in the end for y'all, okay? Hey my loves, welcome or welcome back to another video. As you guys can see by the title, this is gonna be a story time. Yeah, I'm just gonna get right into the story time because I gotta leave soon. So the faster the better. Okay, period. Before we get into the video, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at RikaBabe_dot. Guys, I have to get used to it because I just made it. But yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, this video takes place when I was in high school. As you guys know, because I've said it before on my channel, I hung out with a lot of boys. That's how I was my whole life, though. Like, when I was in high school, when I was in middle school, when I was in elementary, I just hung out with a lot of guys because, like, guys are less drama and they're a vibe. I've never done anything with any of these boys, just saying, but they're a vibe. So we just hung out. We just stayed where the drama was not, okay? Which it ended up being a lot of drama anyway. But anywho, so yeah, there's two main guys in the story and me. We're gonna call one of the guys, we're gonna call him Red. Red was my best friend when I was in high school. He was just my guy best friend. Like, he was just so chill, he was just so cool. And we just clicked and we vibed and he became my best friend. The other guy in the story, we're gonna call him Black. I'm just going with the colors of my room, red and black. So I'm just saying Black. So Black was one of the guys that I was talking to. Backstory, V1. I ended up talking to Black because after school, we used to all just chill together at school before we went home. And Black told my friend that he had, like, that he liked me, thought I was cute. So my friend came to me, she was like, Rika, like, Black thinks you're cute and I think you should talk to him. And I was like, no, because one, I wasn't the kind of girl that was just gonna talk to everyone. Two, he wasn't attractive to me. Three, it wasn't gonna be that. But me and my friend, we talked about it. Me and this girl no longer talk anymore, which is so messed up. But anywho, yeah, so me and my friend ended up talking about it and she got me to talk to him. So I ended up talking to Black. I was talking to Black and I wasn't really interested in the relationship because, like I said, I wasn't. Let me just say this. I said relationship. It was not a relationship. It was really just us talking. We never got to a relationship. It never made it to a relationship. It was never a relationship. I'm just going to say that again, okay? Yeah. I didn't really want to talk to him. It was just like a whatever thing. But anyway, so we ended up talking. We're talking, la la la, living our best lives. And one day, I realized we, like, stopped talking. Like I said, because I wasn't really indulging in the relationship because I didn't really care. It wasn't even a relationship. We were just talking. But because I didn't really care that much, I didn't realize that, like, we stopped talking for a while. So when I realized that we stopped talking, I was like, wait a second. What's going on? So I just wanted to know. Like, I didn't really care if we talked or not, like I said, but I still wanted to know what was going on, why he stopped talking to me. Because, baby, if it was going to be somebody stopped talking to someone, it was going to be me stopped talking to him. But why you stopped talking to me? Now I want to know. So, mind you, the whole, like, of us talking, it was weird because Red, like I said, Red was my best friend, right? So Red, there was a time we were chilling in the hallway, all of us were chilling in the hallway on our phones. We were right in front of the fan because baby was hot, and I was sitting down with my legs crossed on my phone and he was lying down, but he lied down on my knee. Like, when I say my knee, like, right here, this area right here. This area right here, he lied down on my knee, and I didn't think anything of it because, like I said, we're all friends. Like, I lean on my friends, they lean on me. He was lying down while he was on his phone as well. So while we were all chilling, Black entered the hallway. When Black entered the hallway, he, like, gave me a look, but I didn't really like peep it. I didn't really care until when he gave me the look. Red, like when Red saw black, he kind of like sat up real quick. So I was like, okay, like whatever. Like I didn't really care. But it would be little things like that that I wasn't paying attention to, because like I said, I didn't really care. Like when I was in high school, I was just chilling. I was just vibing. Like I didn't really care about much, okay? I was just caring about me, okay? Period. So yeah. So fast forward now, I realized that we're not talking anymore. And like I said, I didn't really care, but I wanted to know what was going on. So I went to him, I was like, why? Like, what's going on? And he was like, what do you mean? And I was like, I just realized that we're not talking anymore. He's like, yeah, because I just realized you're not interested. And he said something along the lines of like, oh, I just realized that you're not interested, and it you're clearly like talking to black or whatever, so I'm gonna let you have it. Talking to black, I said, who? I was like, that's fine that you don't want to talk to me anymore, but I'm not talking to black. Like, because at the time I did not know that black liked me. I didn't know. So I was like, what are you talking about? Like, I'm not talking to black. He was like, yeah, well, I mean, I'm not talking to Red. I was like, I'm not talking to Red. And he was like, oh, well, Red told me, before I get into the tea about what Red told him, I'm gonna rewind a bit. Me and Red were really close. We were close. He was my best friend. We were close to the point where, like, we would always be on the phone. Sometimes we would be messaging each other every day. Like, it would just be that. But that was because he was my best friend. I did not think anything else of it. Now, what? I'm not gonna lie and say that I never liked him. I had feelings for him for a little bit before we became friends. I'm the kind of person where if I start liking you, but then we become friends, like, there's no, like, I don't really see us dating after that, because we're so close now that we became friends. And that's what it was with Red. So at first, when I first met him, I was like, kind of cool. Like, I kind of like him. But when I realized that we established a friendship before a relationship, I was dead in the whole situation of me liking him. And I cut it off. And I didn't even like him after that, because I realized that, okay, we're just friends. I didn't know that he had feelings for me or whatever. I don't even know if he did or what, but when I tell you what happened, he had to have liked me or something, because there's no way he didn't like me, and he said what he said and he did what he did. Okay? Period. So as for now, I'm talking to Black and I'm like, okay, well, what do you mean? Like, I'm not talking to Red. And he was like, oh, well, Red told me that you sent him nudes. Guys, I have been lied on a lot in my life, okay? But that one was the first outrageous I've ever heard, only because I've
never sent pictures in my life. I'm just gonna put the word pictures over the word, because I don't know if you can say that word on YouTube. So yeah.
Life, okay? Never sent.
Pictures.
When he told me this, I kind of stood there and I was laughing, because I thought he was kidding. Okay. So I was like, you're kidding, right? And he was like, no, like, he told me that you sent him. So I figured you guys were talking, because whatever. And I was like, did you see? He was like, no, but he told me that you sent them. So, and I was like, okay, first of all, I don't care if we don't talk anymore, but you're wrong for believing him. Especially when you didn't see no proof. One. Two, I said, you're wrong for the fact that you didn't come to me. Regardless of how our talking stage was, you should have messaged me and asked me if it was true, and I would have clarified it or not. But the fact that you sat up there and believed him and stopped talking to me, I don't even care. You can have that. But I'm gonna go find Black and Red, okay? Y'all are mixing up these names. I'm gonna go find Red, okay? So I did exactly that, and I went to go find Red, and I was with my friends. Now, a little backstory on me at this time. I was very quiet because, like I said before, if you guys know the story times on my channel before, I didn't have like a group of friends because they stopped talking to me. Like, till the you guys will see, there's a video on my channel that I posted about like friendships or whatever, and we stopped talking. So around this time, it's like when I first found like Leah, Shauna, like the people that I had. It was around that time when I first kind of met them, so they didn't really know how I was. So I was very quiet, I was very reserved. Nothing really brought me out of my character until this day. Until this day. So I went to go find Red, and I found Red, and he was talking to one of the hall monitors. If you guys know me in high school, you know I was very disrespectful sometimes. when I got out of character. Like I said, I was very quiet and reserved, so my friends have never seen me loud. But this was the day where they seen a different side of me, because I was very upset because you don't lie on nobody like that. So I found him and he was talking to a homeowner and I did not care. I said, hey, hi. First of all, when he saw me, it was like best friend vibes. Like, ooh, like he was, you know, because of course when you see your best friend, you're happy. But when I opened my mouth, oh, his whole demeanor changed. Let me tell you what happened. So I said red. He was like, yeah. I was like, why did you tell Black that I sent you? Guys, when I tell you, he started treating me the way how I've never seen him treat me before. Mind you, I've seen him out of character before, but not towards me. He's never been out of character with me, but baby, oh, he got out of character this day, and I put him all back together. Disclaimer, this was all before my saved days. So whatever I did in the story time, this was before I got saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. I'm just letting y'all know, because there's going to be a little story. There's going to be a little something in the end for y'all. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, so I said to him, why did you tell Black that I sent you? I repeated it. I said, why did you tell Black that I sent you?
Basically, I was just telling him that the pictures that I sent him, I need to see them, and I need to see them now, because I never took no pictures to send to nobody.
I don't even remember taking no pictures. So if I took pictures and sent them, I need to see them, and I need to see them now. Mind you, when I said I was gonna go find Red, Black came along, because Black wanted the tea too. So it was me, it was Black, it was my friends. I don't remember which. I know Leo was there for a fact, but I don't remember who else was there. I think the girl who made me and Black talk were there as well. I remember she was there, but I don't remember if she came with us or if she came after. But I remember she was there on the scene too. So we're all there, and now the boys are coming. My friends are coming, and it's just me, Red, and the hall monitor having a conversation, but everyone's standing around. Not everybody. I don't want to make it seem like it was a huge thing, but it was quite a few people, because I remember my friends were there, and I was there, Red was there, Black was there, and then there was, like, other ball team boys that came after. So, I guess when he saw his friends, but baby, when I tell you this boy started violating me, he was like...
He was basically just saying, out of all the girls in the school, why would I want pictures from you? He's like, you're not all that. Why would I even want pictures from you? And all that stuff. Like, guys, really going
on for real. First of all, I was shook. I'm not gonna lie. I wasn't even cute like that in high school. I was not cute at all in high school. But you're not about to lie. What you're not gonna do is lie. And make it seem like I am not all that and a bag of chips to you. What he wasn't gonna do is disrespect me. Because the thing is, there was a guy that was there that I liked, okay? And it wasn't Black. It was another guy on the ball team that I liked. And while he was trying to violate me in front of the guy, I wasn't trying to have it, because he was not about to disrespect me, okay? Because they were not about to get a kiki out of me. So I had to get him together. I was like, I'm not about to go back and forth with you, because the things that I'm about to say is about to get real disrespectful, because I had a lot on him. I had a lot on him, okay? And I could have said it and got very much even with him, but I wasn't going to. I said, you're not going to disrespect me, but what I want you to do is show me the pictures that I sent you. We're going back and forth, and all I was saying was, I want to see the pictures. And where I was at this point, there wasn't no, like, I'm about to walk away. It was, I'm going to fight. So I had my fist balled up, and I said, I want to see the pictures. He's going off. I said, I want to see the pictures. The hall monitor, he was ready to de-escalate the situation. Leah was scared for her life, because she's never seen me like this. But one thing about it, two things for sure. I always said it. Is it wrong? Yes. But when I was in middle school, I used to fight boys. I used to fight anybody. I wasn't scared of anybody. I used to fight boys and girls. Anybody who wanted it, they could have got it. When I got to high school, nothing changed.
I do want to say this was my mindset around grade 10 only, because I was freshly... I entered the school with two girls that I call my best friends. And then after grade 9, we were no longer friends. So when I was in grade 10, I was really by myself. So that was just my mindset. When I was in middle school, yes, I used to fight a lot. Like, not a lot. It was mainly just me playing around with boys. But, like, when they would take my phone and run into the boys' bathroom, I would, like... fight them for it and stuff like that. But when I got to high school, I didn't really do that much because it's a new environment. But once I got to grade 10 and I was by myself because the girls that I entered the school would stop talking to me, that part of me still was kind of there because, of course, I was by myself and I was not about to make nobody clown me just because I was by myself. But that was my mindset for grade 10. Grade 11 and 12, it wasn't really like that. Of course, I changed. I didn't really fight at all, period. I only got into one fight all of high school. And yeah, I only really got into one fight, and that was when I think I was turning 18 or when I was turning 17, but it wasn't my mindset to fight.
All my friends were like, Rika, like, let's go. And I just didn't want to go. I did not want to go. But he kept going buck, like, oh, why would I want your picture? Like, he tried to violate me in front of all these people.
And then
he's walking away from me, and the whole situation got de-escalated because he's walking away. I'm about to walk behind you, even though I was really thinking about it. I was really thinking about it. I wanted all the smoke. But anyways, so yeah. So fast forward years later, mind you, I don't know if I've ever saw him. I don't remember ever seeing him after that because I removed him from social media, because you're not going to lie on me. I removed him, not on Instagram, because when I stop talking to people, I don't really block people. It's whatever. But on Snapchat, I removed him. You're not about to see me. You can see him on Instagram, but that's about it. On Snapchat, I removed him and I just stopped talking to him. If I ever did see him in person, I never talked to him. I walked past him like I didn't know this man from a can of paint. Mind you, he was my best friend. I don't care. You lie like that, it's clipped for you and me. So years later, when I started college, I got a friend request. And I was like, what the heck? When I looked at the friend request, it was him. And why do I know it was him? Because his name was in the, so it basically was like red 1922, whatever. It was basically like his name or whatever. He had a very distinct nickname, and the nickname was his snap name. So I was like, what does this guy want? So I accepted the request because although he lied on me, to me it wasn't that serious because I knew it was a lie. And the person he lied to, I didn't really care. But yeah, so I accepted a friend request and I was like, okay, whatever, like, it's dead, it was years ago, it's whatever. And when I would post something, he would send me like heart eyes and stuff like that. He would be like, oh, you're such a ghost, and da da da, like, we don't talk, whatever. So one day I was like, me, I'm a ghost? I was like, did you forget what happened? And he was like, what are you talking about? So he was like, send me your number. So I gave him my number, and he called me and he was like, bro, like, why are you such a ghost? Like, why don't we talk anymore? And I was like, do you forget what happened? And he started laughing. He knew exactly what he did. And he was just like, bro, it's not even like that. He was like, I just didn't want you talking to him and whatever. And I was like, I said to him, I was like, I didn't want to talk to him either. But the fact that you lied on me and I had like no parts in it, I didn't know anything about it, that's what had me messed up, because I was shook when he told me that. And he was like, I know, like, I'm sorry, like, let's just move past it, da da da. And we moved on. Like, we were cool after that, because like I said, he was my best friend. And to be honest, the lie in and of itself, which is this is the part where I'm gonna speak to young people. The lie in and of itself was messed up. It was. It definitely was. But I am a kind of person where I know who I am. And if you want to believe those things, that's fine. That's what I told Black. I said, if you want to believe it, that's fine. But you're wrong for not telling me, but I'm gonna go find Red. So at the end of the day, I know who I am, and I know for a fact that I would never send him pictures. I've never sent anybody pictures, so I know for a fact that I would never send pictures, and I know for a fact that I didn't send him pictures. But do not take the fact that me talking back to him diminishes anything that he did, because what he did was wrong. If it had been, this is where I'm talking to young people, young men in general, do not lie on females' bodies, because you do not know what kind of self-esteem, what kind of confidence, you do not know what they're going through. And you have to be careful of who you tell things to, because that lie could have very much ended me. Like I said, I know who I am, and I know what, like, I know what is what. And I know at the end of the day, he had no proof. And Black told me himself he didn't see the pictures. So there, he very well was lying. But another person, another female who doesn't know how to deal with this stuff, doesn't know anything, you give her a wrong reputation. You say this, and the thing is, guys pillow talk. When I say pillow talk, y'all don't have to be laying in a bed chilling to be pillow talking. They hang out with each other. We all know men have group chats with each other. I don't know when he said it to Black. I don't know if he said it to Black in the midst of a bunch of people. I don't know if he said it to Black in passing. I don't know when he said it to Black. This is the thing. And when you're saying these things, you have to be careful of what you say and who you say it to and who's around. Because now, what if it was a situation where I was very much low self-esteem, didn't care about myself and all this stuff, and you sent me over the edge? That one lie that you did because you didn't want me to talk to someone could have very well turned into something else. It could have turned into I can't say the words on here, but it could have turned into me ending myself. You know what I mean? Because that happens. We hear it in social media a lot where young people, they end their lives because lies that were told on them, or because they trusted someone sending people pictures and they posted it and now they unalive themselves because the pressure is too much. And the thing is, it's not something to joke about. I can laugh about the situation now because, like I said, there was no proof and I know who I am and I know that there was never actually any pictures. So it's whatever. And I know that I felt good in myself because I confronted him in front of everybody. And right then and there, the whole lie, everything was broken because I confronted him in front of everyone. And right there in front of everyone, he said, oh, Black is lying. I didn't say that you sent me any pictures. Why would I want pictures from you? So right then and there, it clearly shows that he didn't even have no pictures of me to begin with, right? But you never know. And this is why you have to be careful what you say about people and who you say it to, because you never know what words can do to someone. And I know they always have this saying, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words can never hurt me. That saying is not true because, yes, sticks and stones may break your bones, but words can also hurt you. We see a lot of times in social media where words have taken people's lives. Words have taken people away from their families. Words have diminished people's character. Words have broken people down. And although this is a situation that happened in high school, and I can laugh about it and talk about it because me, like I said, me and the guy were cool now and all that stuff, at the end of the day, if this was just to spread and bring awareness to just different things in life, because you never know what you say can, how it can affect people. And although it didn't really affect me much because, like I said, the guy who I was talking to, he like stopped talking to me because he thought I was talking to Red, but I didn't really care because I didn't want to talk to Black anyways. I said it in a joke when I said that the person who he was trying to disrespect me in front of was one of the guys that I liked. At the end of the day, I said it as a joke, but you never know, because what if because of that he looked at me as, oh, this girl's easy, this girl's this, this girl's that, you know what I mean? Of course he didn't, because but anywho, I'm not gonna say what I was gonna say, but of course he, the guy that I like, didn't think that, because talking later. But you just never know, and you want to be careful of what you say about people and who you say it to, because you never know. And this is not to him, because like I said, it was never that serious for me, but it could be something serious for someone else. So you guys want to be careful of what you say about people and what you say, who you say it to, because you never know. Like, Black took it with a grain of salt. He moved on. That I know of. I don't know if he told anybody. But what if he was the kind of person that was like, bet this girl's dirty, I'm about to tell everybody. He told the whole school, and now I'm sitting here like, I have nobody to defend me. Because Leah and them, yes, they were my friends, but they didn't know me like that. They didn't know how I get down. Because, like I said, we just became friends. We weren't that close. So, like, they don't know how I get down. They're probably thinking, like, yes, they would probably protect me, but they don't know me like that. But yeah, guys, that was the story about how a young man who was my best friend at the time lied on my body. Imagine that, girl. But anyways, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at RikaBabe_. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend, because your girl is back and better than ever. Bye, my loves.